see that. So someone's been sleeping in this bed. Who's been sleeping in my bed?
It's quite not very wide. I think that's probably about 4 foot.
Yeah, 4 foot.
Two, yeah, something like that.
Yeah. It's the bathroom light. Dark.
toilet at the end and
yeah.
Shower curtain. So it's a wet room.
Yeah. It's what you call a wet room, isn't it?
This is
nice. It's a good sized kitchen, reasonable amount of worktop.
A microwave?
Most vans seem to have a microwave now, don't they? I don't think I've seen a van today that's not had a microwave in it.
Three gas burner hob.
Yeah.
Petrol.
Yeah, combi oven.
Combi oven, yeah.
Hanging space.
That's quite nice.
Yeah. You won't have to carry those cushions around with you, but.
It's made the bed up at the front.
Yeah.
It's a nice extractor bed. It's a deep special.
Yeah.
That's probably something
thoughtfully fitted as an extractor fan. We had one in the Starfire, didn't we?
Yeah, we did. Yeah.
Really, really useful.
Good. Yeah.
It's not a bad little dinette here. It's about the same size as ours, really, isn't it? Which was
a little bit higher up, aren't you, and me?
In this travel seat.
Travel seats.
So it's a little bit difficult to use it from the travel seat because you've got the step there, haven't you? In our van, the step is over there.
That's right. Just like a Bailey Compact, isn't it? Because those two front seats were higher up.
Nice. You felt like you were sitting on a throne, didn't you?
Looking down on it.
Yeah, that's right. And this is a twin sofa model. So go on. Right. You've got your kitchen at the end. Yeah, so it's got these enormous sofas. They must be 6'2" or something. Great old sofas.
You could just use them as a bed, couldn't you?
Yeah, I could easily sleep lengthwise in that. But this is a layout that's very similar, albeit a little bit bigger than what we had in the Starfire, isn't it?
Yeah.
You've got your fridge over here. Yeah, TV points up here. Microwave, as the person just left the van said, way too high up there. You've got what's a corner bathroom. Yeah. Reasonable shower. Electric hot plate, decent sized worktop, huge sink. These are nice, these are always nice. These pop up or pop down wherever you do it. I'm not going to do it now. But plugs come up there. Quite sure you need three of them, but.
It's brilliant for having people round because you've got all this seating.
Yeah.
It's quite nice for just two of you to lounge in.
Yeah.
And when you stop somewhere, it's quite relaxing.
Yeah.
And
if I was using this, I'd probably just put a pillow up and a sleeping bag.
Yeah.
And your bed's done, so you don't have to make the beds up. I mean, if you did make the bed up, you could have three in a bed, couldn't you?
Well, yeah. Poppy as well. Yeah.
Sleeper Warwick Duo. So this is, I think the Duo bit refers to the fact it's just two berths because you've got no travel seats apart from driver and passenger, of course. Reasonable facilities at the front there.
A lot of drawers.
Three burner cooker, combi oven. Just manoeuvre around. Probably can't see that. for a light in here. Can't see where the light for it is, but it's a very compact washer.
But then you've got this.
But then you've got a massive seating area. Yeah. Which sort of makes up for having no travel seats, I guess. Apart from the fact that you can't take anyone with you. It's a Lunar RLS. 51,000. Automatic transmission. Total 65,193. There's another rear lounge van. Very nice. Similar sort of layout to the Warwick Duo, but it's got a Mercedes badge. Automatic. And there's an Optima T65G. What's amazing about a lot of these vans now is that a lot of them are under 3,500 kilograms.
Then you've got to check your payload.
Well, yeah. I mean, obviously you've got to check what you can take with you. But they're all trying to get under that magic figure. And you see the size of this van. This is a 7-metre van, isn't it?
Yeah. Very light cupboard. It's probably worth saved, isn't it?
Yeah. Probably it's all hollow, I expect, isn't it? It's more of a camper style hob, that.
Yeah. Sink.
This is what you find with continental vans, though, isn't it? That you end up with a tiny little, if
like
at all.
That.
I'm not even sure what that is. Is it a grill? It's just a grill, isn't it?
Well, I think so.
Yeah. Small oven grill.
It's slow down.
Yeah. Let's have a look in here. Squeeze. But yeah, good length bed, I would guess.
No, I don't want to risk banging my head again.
Yeah, you're not going to bang your head. Up.
Yes.
Yeah.
Sit on the couch.
Sit on the table.
You're right here at the top.
Yeah, I'll do that. Half an inch of headroom. Let's have a look in the bathroom.
Well, that'll be the bathroom.
Well, they're written in here.
Yeah.
Well, that's quite impressive. It goes back. And you've got some hanging space. And I presume it comes forward somehow. So it protects the. Yeah. Oh, yeah. So I said. So that goes all the way round to shut off the shower.
Yeah.
That's clever. When you opened it, it's got a nice big area, haven't you? What chair's like?
Table.
Yeah, they always give you great big tables. They've got two layers. Obviously, one slides out, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah. Curtains, net curtains. Little dicky seats.
Not bad, but it's quite long.
Yeah, it's a reasonable size, isn't it? Yeah.
I always do these because you know, got travel seats, yeah. Got these seats here.
Yeah.
Table,
yeah.
Then I look in the bedroom on those steps and the bed up high.
Yeah.
And look as we are.
Yeah. This is a Bailey Autograph 794T. Yours from 56,995. This is actually 3,850 kilograms. So it's C1 license territory like ours. I don't know why they can't make it 4,250. Well, it could, couldn't you? Makes no difference.
It's nearly 8 metres long.
Yeah.
And nearly 2.5 metres wide.
So it's 2, yeah.
2.
Yeah.
And it's 9 foot tall.
Really. 9 foot one tall.
How tall are we?
About the same tall.
About the same.
About 4 inches less wide. Of course, the thing about it being so wide is it's almost like that motor trek one. Because you end up with a huge sort of floor space here. TV's up there. And a little
bracket
thing.
I just thought it's great over here, but I don't know how that bracket would...
Well, you could probably turn the bracket round, couldn't you? Probably face it round that way.
Yeah, not that I can sit in my seat anyway.
No, because Poppy's always got it, so I don't know what you're worrying about. Reasonable size work surface. They've got a chopping board sink cover.
Yeah, that's nice. That's a clever idea, that.
Yeah, it's like an integrated hob, this, so it's quite different because it's more like an integrated kitchen, isn't it?
Mm.
Built into the top.
Yeah.
Combi oven at the bottom. Go on, have a look at these drawers. These drawers are huge, aren't they? They're deep and they're wide.
Yeah. Just got the sink.
Yeah.
Oh, it's a drainer, isn't it?
It's a drainer.
And another drawer.
Yeah, I think that other one is a bit smaller, if I remember.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Is that because the gas is there?
Gas
side.
Is there, isn't it?
And
then you've got these blooming great lockers. You have to stand back to film it. I should have been wide angle for that, shouldn't I?
Never quite sure about this, if something's going to fall out the opposite side to which you're looking in.
Go donk. Big fridge.
Now, what's the difference with the fridge in here?
The difference with the fridge in here is that you have to physically put it onto whatever you need. You have to remember to do that. So yeah. If you're going along, you have to remember to put it onto battery. If you're off hookup, you put it onto that. Sorry, you put it onto that gas. And if you're driving, you have to have it on that.
Yeah.
Why can't they do energy selection?
We're always forgetting, aren't we?
We're always forgetting to switch the fridge, and you end up with defrosted food that you can't eat.
Yeah. Yeah. Now this is quite like this bedroom, isn't it?
Yeah.
And you know it's got a step, but
it's under a tiny step.
Yeah.
So what's that? 3 inches?
3 inches, that's sort of like nothing.
I think you can manage that. You don't even bang your head?
No, which is a bonus.
Yeah. I mean, we'd definitely be tempted by this van. It's a really nice sort of decor in here, isn't
it? Yeah, it is.
Charging points. Charging for your phone.
Lights.
That's the switch for the lights, isn't it? That is, yeah.
Yeah.
Telepoint, presumably, over here. They haven't fitted a bracket, but...
No, I've seen them when they fitted that, and the telly's there.
Yeah. So you've got a humongous drawer under the bed.
Yeah. Could you put all your tops and everything in there?
Well, yeah.
We've got a wardrobe.
Massive order. Oh, that's so deep as well. It goes way back over.
Wow. It's certainly easier to get in.
Yeah.
Look, the folding door.
Door to shut it off.
Yep. Another wardrobe
over there, which you can't see because it's dark. That's because I've drawn this door, isn't it?
Probably.
Still can't see it. Never mind. And then a centre bathroom. So. Now for a centre washroom, this is really good.
Yeah, I've thought that before because it's a reasonable shower, isn't it?
Yeah. Another big cupboard.
Yeah. It's so white and big looking in here. You've got this folding door, isn't it?
Triple fold doors, aren't they? They fold across there, don't they?
And of course, one of the best features is the hanging
thing. Actually, the sofa feature, really, sell it for me. That sold it for me. Is that you've got a hanging washing line.
Yeah. Very nice.
Yeah, I mean, it's good for awnings. No bikes would go in there, but.
No.
But then, I don't know why you need to put bikes in there when you can put them on the back.
Yeah.
And you've got these really nice brake light cluster things.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's a car high style. $3,850. First thing you notice about this is a massive sunroof, isn't it? Travel seats. I've got to be honest, what puts us off this van is not anything else, it's the height of these beds. I can't lift myself up onto it.
No.
I've got this step thing here. Presumably you have to fold that away.
Yeah.
But they are. I mean, look how high it is. I mean, there's my elbow.
Your elbow's there.
Yeah. So what's that? And you're 5 foot. What are you? Five foot four and a half.
Yeah.
So they're about 4.5 feet.
Yeah.
Off the deck. Yeah.
Shower.
Yeah, it's a good shower room. The table's in a little
cupboard of its own with.
That's bizarre.
What do we do with this space?
You're only just about get my arm in there. Oh, good
and
grief.
You can maneuver the table out of there. This busy area.
Mm.
No, this isn't.
Not doing it for us.
Doing it.
Right, this is Elddis Chatsworth, which is a dealer at Gossip Caravans, 195. Again, 3,500. Oh, I remember this one. Come on, you've got to sit on the seat. Yes, and it's in a well, isn't it?
I still don't like this.
I think it's good if you've got perhaps a kid who occasionally come with you.
Yeah, then it would be okay.
Yeah, and the thing about it is it folds away, and then you've got two sofas. So
yeah, it's just for travelling. I mean, it's only come in halfway. On the leg.
Yeah.
It's really stiff at the back.
Yeah. Yeah.
Alright. I wouldn't want to go the distance in
it. It's a very long caravan, this. Caravan, motorhome even. See, I'm getting tired now, calling it a caravan. It's got a lovely lounge at the back.
Yeah.
Really long lounge. Oh, I think we'll just lounge here a bit now. It comes with all the shampoos that you'll ever need. That's a wet room, isn't it? The wet floor. Doesn't seem to be like a shower curtain. Oh yes, there is up there. Only a short one there. It won't keep it off the door. Well, you've got a massive wardrobe, you can't really see it with all these cushions in there. So there's two hanging rails there. The table's in there.
Yeah.
The table will
come out.
Table go there.
Pull out from there. That's just a cupboard.
Yeah. So they haven't done like a caravan table here, have they?
No.
That would be a nice idea if you had a table that came out like a caravan. Are we done?
I think we're just about done.
Yeah, if we spot anything interesting just wandering around, we'll film that.
Yeah, but otherwise I think we're
tuckered,
aren't we?
We're tuckered.
Rescue puppy.
Yeah. So what did you think of the show?
Well, I'm surprised how busy it was.
Yeah. It's going to be even busier on Sunday.
Even busier on Sunday, yeah. It's crammed into a smallish area, isn't it?
Yeah.
It seems if things are sort of on top of each other. But,
yeah.
No, it's quite enjoyed it.
Yeah.
You?
Yeah. Yeah, it's good. It's warm in here. It's absolutely warm in here. Yeah, I think we'd get here a little bit earlier than we did. We were a bit stuck in traffic.
And also we had the problems with storms last night, didn't we?
Yeah.
Lakes of that, bins everywhere.
Yeah.
Yeah, so
that's it. I'll leave it to that. Right, so what do you think of the show?
It was a lot busier than I expected it to be. I mean, just looking at all the car parks and everything, how full they are. It's in a slightly too small area, possibly, because everything was sort of
I've seen one
squashed.
Big hole, isn't it?
Yeah. Although there's
unless
all
we missed
three.
A hole.
No, I don't think so, because you seem to go in and you were soon in all three.
Yeah, it's effectively over two halls, isn't
yeah.
it?
Yeah. A lot of Swifts, although, a lot of Swift caravans.
Yeah. There's a huge number of caravans there.
Yeah.
I think there's more caravans than motorhomes.
Yeah, possibly.
Yeah. Apologies if you were expecting us to look at caravans. We looked at one, I think, didn't we?
Yeah, we did. Yeah.
I mean, the only thing I was saying is one of the things we wanted to do on this episode, is, as it were, was to look at layouts, to try and look at different layouts.
Yeah.
So you've seen like drop-down beds, rear lounges, pull-together sofas, beds that are up in the air, beds that are not up
in
the air.
That's right. The Bailey with a reasonable level, all that.
Yeah.
But Bessica, well, they were, I think that's the highest we saw.
Nearly 5 foot up, weren't they?
Yeah.
It seemed to be. But yeah, there's different, what's it called, different strokes for different folks.
Yeah, and it's all what area you want. Is your priority, isn't it, really, most of the time?
Yeah.
Perhaps ours is going to sleep and having a nice bathroom.
Yeah, I think we could do with a sleep now.
Yeah.
It was an early start this morning with all the wind and everything. And anyway, stop moaning.
Yeah, so...
We're happy with what we've got.
Yeah.
But yeah, I'd definitely recommend a visit to the Manchester show. I think it's as big, if not bigger, than the Glasgow one.
Yeah. But I'd say come early in the morning before it gets very, very busy.
I mean, what's amazed me, we've come on Thursday thinking it was going to be quiet. What's it going to be like on Sunday?
No, or Saturday.
Yeah.
Even.
Yeah. Car park's absolutely full.
Yeah, right. So no, we'd come again, wouldn't we, next year?
Yeah.
And now we're looking forward to the... Glasgow show,
yeah.
Because we've got longer there, haven't we? We've got the full day is.
Yeah, because we're staying in Glasgow, so we can come and go. So we'll probably do 2-3 days there.
Yeah, and we might have a caravan day.
Yeah, yeah, we could do that. We could have a caravan and a camper van day, couldn't we?
Yeah.
And perhaps spend a bit longer in the vans. I think this has been like a whistle stop tour.
Well, that's right.
Of what you can see there. Mm. Yeah. Anyway, if you like what you see, subscribe. And hit the notifications bell and you'll get updates when we're going on our next little trip.
And that's to Burr's Country Park, isn't it, on
this
week today?
Yeah, we're going on the, what's it called, the Lancastrian Lunch on the East Lancashire Railway. So that should be good. We've got permission to film.
Yeah, so...
And,
looking
forward
to that.
All right, we'll see you soon.
Yep, bye.